one's ever done me.
Last night I had a dream that I had a baby, and I was a lady that had a baby with her husband, and we were amongst people and we were talking, and the baby that I had, well, the baby was in a stroller, and the baby appeared to be maybe about 5-6 months old, and as we were talking and stuff, there appeared to be some type of green snake in some bushes type area. I don't know. But the snake, everybody was talking, and then all of a sudden we focused on that snake. And a man came, and he went ahead and picked the snake up. And I was relieved because somebody at least got it, you know? But something strange happened. He was walking over towards me holding that snake. And he wasn't just walking towards me. He was walking towards the baby in that I was pushing in the stroller. So he got close to the baby with the snake, and the man seemed harmless. He just seemed like he was talking to other people. So I just went ahead and just took some steps back away from the snake, pulling the stroller with me, and the man kept talking to the people and walking towards me every time I backed up. So I kept backing up, and he kept walking towards me. And I kept backing up with the baby stroller, and he kept walking towards me. And he would stop when the snake's head was directly above the baby stroller within striking distance. And I would, you know, now I'm getting a little upset, and I'm not understanding him. So I'm backing up, and I'm stumbling over things, and I don't understand why he keeps doing this. And, you know, acting as if he doesn't understand that I'm trying to get away from him. Then the snake comes and strikes the baby on the forehead. And there's a metallic mark on the baby's forehead. And it's a golden metallic mark. And I become alarmed. And everybody becomes stressed out. And the man starts to fake apologize and say, and really look sincere, but he was faking it. And acting as if he didn't know what happened. So we took the baby to, and I think the snake bit somebody else, but we took the baby to the hospital. And the hospital, you know, said that they would take care of it and all that stuff. But behind the closed doors, the doctors and nurses, they knew they couldn't do anything about it, but they would pretend that they could to somehow calm the people. And I wasn't going to even mention this dream. I really wasn't. It's just that it kept bothering me all day long. So I said, Lord, you know, if you want me to share it, I'll share it, you know? And what's coming in my heart and in my spirit is that the children are in danger of the mark of the beast. We know that the mark of the beast is here. And we should not get anything with any microchip on it. Nothing with anything called luciferous on it. Nothing. Nothing, nothing, nothing. You know, we know that the mark of the beast, we know that it's a microchip. We know that the microchip is attached to the internet, which has the www, which is the vav in Hebrew, which is the number 666. We know that the quantum dot tattoo has something, an enzyme called luciferase on it. And that's the name of the beast, Lucifer. You know, we know that all microchips are computers, and a program to buy and sell can be easily added to it. We know that nobody will make it that has the mark of the beast. Read Revelation chapter 13 and 14.
Studying about that good old way, and who shall wear a starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down. Come on down, come on down. Oh, sisters.